Por motivo de la reciente desaparición del líder de Nirvana, en MTV decidimos rendirle un tributo a lo que podría ser una de las agrupaciones más importantes de esta década, con un especial de 3 horas que resume la historia de Nirvana, desde su origen hasta la tragedia de la cual han sido protagonistas en los últimos meses. Esta comenzó cuando el líder de Nirvana, Kurt Cobain, se suicidó el pasado abril. Dejó, entre otras cosas, una gran incógnita. ¿Sufría Cobain de depresión clínica, una enfermedad que pareció afectarlo por muchos de sus 27 años, o era simplemente un egoísta y ególatra que partió sin pensar en su esposa y especialmente en la hija que dejaba? La pregunta continúa sin respuesta. De lo que no hay duda es de la calidad y carisma de la música de Nirvana. Como cantante y compositor principal de la agrupación, Cobain no pareció adaptarse al mundo comercial a la que su música le llevaba. A pesar de que las letras de sus canciones podrían ser tan personales, al punto de ser impenetrables, también reflejaban una necesidad de conectarse con la gente. El haberse quitado la vida tan solo 3 años después de haber conquistado una audiencia internacional es como si dijéramos que Pete Townshend, el genio detrás del grupo The Who, hubiese renunciado antes de sacar el clásico álbum Who's Next. En realidad, nunca sabremos cuán excelente música se ha perdido. Afortunadamente, lograron grabar bastante antes del final. Ataques sónicos encabezados por fortísimos solos de guitarra que podían competir con el mejor rock de las décadas pasadas. Nunca sabremos lo que hubiese podido suceder, pero sí podemos mirar atrás y observar lo que quedó. Empecemos por el principio.
Well, the band started in 1987 in a small coastal town in Aberdeen, Washington.
I'd been playing guitar for about 3 years before I started a band. I couldn't find anyone in my hometown to play with, so I met Chris.
Una primera versión de In Bloom que se grabó cuando Chad Channing era el baterista del grupo. Cuando regresemos conoceremos al nuevo baterista Dave Grohl y echaremos un vistazo a la realización del álbum Nevermind, un verdadero acontecimiento en la música de los 90. Quédense con nosotros.
I think most of the...
Con Nevermind vendiendo inesperadas multimillones de copias a nivel mundial, contaban repentinamente con suficiente dinero como para financiar el primer lujoso video de Nirvana, Come As You Are.
That was the first, like, sort of big production video, like big production where we came in and they actually had built this elaborate set.
Que buscó en vano por un medicamento que pudiese aliviar su dolor. En desesperación, aparentemente buscó remedio en la heroína.
I was in pain. I mean, I was in pain for so long that I didn't care if I was in a band. I didn't care if I was alive, you know. And it just so happened that I came to that conclusion at a time when my band became really popular, you know. I mean, it had been going on and building up for so many years that I was, you know, suicidal. I mean, I just didn't want to live. So I just thought, if I'm going to die, if I'm going to kill myself, I should take some drugs, you know. May as well become a junkie, because I felt like a junkie every day, you know. You know, waking up starving, forcing myself to eat, you know, barfing it back up. It's like, you know, just imagine trying to eat your three meals a day and just concentrating and just crying at times, just like, I'm in pain all the time, you know. And being on tour was a lot worse, too, you know, it made it even worse.
A pesar de que los problemas estomacales y de drogas de Kurt Cobain iban en ascenso, 1992 fue un año exitoso para Nirvana. El 24 de febrero en Hawái, Cobain se casó con Courtney Love, la cantante y líder del grupo Hole. Nirvana participó en el verano en el Reading Festival, que se celebra anualmente en Inglaterra. También aparecieron como estrellas invitadas en el aclamado show norteamericano Saturday Night Live y, por supuesto, hicieron una inolvidable presentación en los MTV Video Music Awards.
I started playing the song, and all of a sudden the amp was just so overdriven, it started cutting out. And it just died. And so instead of standing there going, duh, I thought I'd do the sensational bass toss. I've got some pretty good air before, so I like, threw it up there, and I had some beers and stuff, and maybe was a little nervous, and it just, I caught it wrong. It just like went, popped me on the head, and it just kind of fell down, and I just ran off stage. And Kurt didn't even know what happened, and I'm like walking off stage. He sees me, and he kicks me in the ass as I walk off stage, of all things. And then... He didn't know what happened. After he told me, he goes, I'm sorry I did that. I didn't know what happened.
The winner is Nirvana. Smells like Teen Spirit.
The winner? Nirvana.
Tan solo tres semanas antes del Video Music Awards, Courtney dio a luz a una niña a la cual llamaron Frances Bean. Al principio, la llegada del bebé pareció darle a Cobain la estabilidad que este necesitaba en su vida.
Right when she was born, that's what was the beginning of taking us out of the slump, because she was like this beam of optimism that came up. Like all of a sudden, there was just all kinds of weird stuff going on, and then all of a sudden there's this baby born, and I think it was like a something really, really, really positive that came out of some kind of hard times, and it was kind of a blessing, and I was really glad to see her there, and everybody was, and Kurt and Courtney were proud parents, and it was really good. It was the best thing that could have happened, to tell you the truth.
Pero los problemas personales de Cobain no se habían desvanecido con el nacimiento de su hija, porque después vino una entrevista en la revista Vanity Fair, la cual sugería que su esposa, Courtney, había consumido heroína durante el embarazo. Courtney negó furiosamente esta alegación.
It's been really damaging to us, to tell you the truth. It's really affected my personal life a lot. I mean, the woman in Vanity Fair came into our house with an agenda. She knew exactly what kind of article she was going to write before she even met us before. She knew that she hated Courtney because of the rumors she'd heard, and she believed them and decided to write a crucifixion piece. It's as simple as that. I mean, we've challenged her with, coming up with the tapes to prove those quotes, and she can't do it. And all the quotes were by inside sources, and no names were made, you know, so it's, it was obviously just a, you know, a crucifixion piece, but I understand that a lot of people have been really affected by that, you know, they believe it. I'm really surprised.
A pesar de que Courtney Love insistió que no madre drogadicta, una corte sentenció que le quitaran al bebé. Les tomó a Kurt y a Courtney más de un mes el recuperar a su hija. Esto fue, en cierta manera, un difícil periodo para ellos, pero Nirvana tomó la oportunidad de hacer un video para la canción In Bloom. que muestra un aspecto hasta el momento desconocido por muchos, el sentido del humor. Quédense con nosotros que ya regresamos. Cuarto video del popular álbum Nevermind, Nirvana se unió con el director Kevin Kerslake para hacer un clip que no solo le demostrara al mundo que eran graciosos, pero que también estaban un poco locos.
I was talking to Kevin about it and I said that I would like him to say something about how nice and clean cut we are, you know, how perfect we are, because, you know, the In Bloom video came out at the height of us being thought of as degenerates, you know, so. You know, we needed a light-hearted video.
Next, ladies and gentlemen, we have three fine young men from Seattle.
That's Doug Llewellyn from People's Court. How cool is that? We tried to get that encyclopedia kid. Remember me? But he was sick.
They're thoroughly all right and decent fellows with their hit single, In Bloom.
It was my idea to come up with that. I thought, I want to do a video that's either from... I wanted something that looked like it was off of live television from the late 50s or early 60s. And I thought the best way to do it, instead of trying to reproduce that effect with new film, I asked Kevin, are those kinescope cameras still available? And he said, yeah, we can get them in Hollywood. You can get anything in Hollywood. So it just worked out perfectly.
Here they are, Nirvana.
In Bloom es el homenaje que Nirvana le rinde al pasado y cursi pop. Para mantener a sus seguidores contentos hasta la llegada del próximo álbum, Nirvana lanzó Incesticide, una colección de canciones hasta el momento desconocidas e inéditas de la agrupación que se remontaban inclusive hasta antes del primer LP. El grupo también hizo un video para este álbum, con la participación especial de Francis Bean Cobain en el tema Sliver.
She wasn't right in the middle of us dancing around and throwing things, you know. We shot us dancing around, and then we put her down, and then, like, just drop paper around her, you know, and then edited it together to make it look like she was, like, at our feet.